In September 2014, the Ferrovial Agroman Laing O'Rourke JV Flow was awarded the Northern Line Extension Project. This is a vital part of the regeneration of Southwest London, comprising two impressive new underground stations at Battersea Power Station and at Nine Elms, with over 3 kilometres of twin tube tunnels created by tunnel boring machines. Amongst the complexities of this major engineering project, there was a particular challenge: how to tie each new railway tunnel into the existing Northern Line Loop Tunnel while maintaining live underground network operations. Each tie-in is facilitated by what is known as a step plate junction. The Northern Line Extension step plate junctions set a new benchmark for such underground construction, as this is the first time such work has been undertaken since the Jubilee Line extension in the 1990s.
Starting off the design of this job, we knew that a 3D model was absolutely essential. So what we had was a very detailed laser survey undertaken, a cloud survey, that gave us very fine resolution on the tunnel lining, the cables and the services in the tunnel, but also the track, because we needed to know exactly how the existing track was working so that we could design a junction that tied on with that track and achieve the journey times that we need to on this project. We wanted to pick the best location so that we can have the shortest amount of tunnel underground. We had an original reference design that we needed to work with, and we were able to significantly improve on that design by reducing the length by about 40%.
In June 2016, the Flow team began construction of the step plate junction by first creating two access shafts, one at Kennington Green and one at Kennington Park.
Well, we start with the existing railway that's down underground. It was built in the 1920s, the section that we're connecting onto. But everything else is about us coming through the mud. And that's done by sprayed concrete line tunnels going through the ground horizontally and then approaching the back of the existing tunnel, getting to see the cast iron that hasn't been seen for just about 100 years.
The Northern Line Extension step plate junctions comprise two steps. The larger sections are 9.5 metres in diameter, enabling much of the excavation to be undertaken mechanically. Following excavation, the team sprayed concrete lining in the new tunnels and then installed iron rings as the permanent tunnel lining, with a custom designed ring erector, a major innovation for the project. The smaller sections of the step plate junction tunnels are 6.5 metres in diameter. Unlike the larger section, there was limited space around the existing tunnel, so traditional hand mining was used. Monitoring of the existing railway was critical. Shape arrays were installed along the existing tunnel lining to continuously monitor any movement against predefined trigger levels. A challenge at Kennington has been undertaking 24/7 tunnelling operations in a densely populated residential area. The Flow team constructed two acoustic enclosures, one at each site, to minimise the impact on nearby residents.
So the innovation that BIM and my role actually brings to the project, it makes things easier, it's more efficient. So we have everything we need in the 3D model. We can check for high-risk areas, spatial constraints. We also provide visualizations from the model. But the point is that we're tackling these problems virtually before we actually go out on site, which means when we build it, we get it right first time.
So in terms of the overall tunneling works, the key was to work towards three possession dates that we had set in stone about 18 months ago. When the possession dates came, we had a target of using 3 weekends to remove all the cast iron rings. We actually removed the whole lot. We removed 226 rings in 1 weekend at both sites, which was an absolutely phenomenal performance. And we did all that without a single accident. It really, really, really was a success story.
While London shut down for the Christmas 2017 holidays, the team worked round the clock at both locations simultaneously during a 10-day blockade on the Northern Line to complete the next phase of work following the September possessions.
So we turned the Northern Line extension tunnels, which is now connected to the Northern Line, connecting it by rail as well.
Construction of the junctions began in September 2016 and were successfully handed over to operational train services in January 2018. By working collaboratively, the team demonstrated that significant mechanical excavation could be carried out around an operational tunnel without affecting railway operations.
This has been a very exciting challenge to be on because these sort of junctions into existing infrastructure don't come about very often. And this is a once in a generation challenge. The lessons we've learned in doing this job, I think, will be relevant when these future works are done to expand London Underground's network in future and other metros. A lot of key lessons in terms of how we use the digital model, how we use technology, spread concrete line tunnels. So I think people will look at this, read about this, and be able to see what we've done and take it forward in the future perhaps as well.